Hello, welcome to another episode on Your Sand Channel, and this is just for educational purpose. I wanted to share those who've been watching and who come to first time to on this Your Sand Channel video. You may wanna, if you're first time, you may wanna go to the previous videos, or you can still watch it. But there are many videos under Sand Channel library, and for this particular video, I wanted to talk about some of the features, because you have seen in the previous video, if you go and watch, you're collecting the data and everything, and then you have this nice beautiful dashboard. And but the point is that when it comes to security and event management and monitoring, you want to do some actions. There is an automation piece also on that, which is SOAR, which I'm not going to talk about. But the thing I'm going to explain, it will handle some piece of the SOAR as well, security automation basically. And there are different areas where you want to fix it, or you want to get some notification or something. Basically, you want to avoid some manual stuff. So, for example, what you see on the screen is you're collecting the data and alerts are being generated. Now what, right? You have all this thing information, but how this information is useful to or not, that's very important. And you're collecting the data from all over. So what you're going to do with that? So let's say you configure it, you have collecting sign-in logs, user signing in, audit logs, Office 365 logs, third-party logs, you know, whichever you collect on the SIEM, which is Sentinel in this case, it can be any SIEM. And now from there onwards, you want to do some actionable items. So one of the example I'm going to cover, and of course, there are a ton of incidents there, which I'll show you, and I did configure one. I'll give you the business case, because which is very common, as long as you have Microsoft 365 configured or any other services. So let's have a look, because we want to do something actionable. So come here to this option. I believe analytics will give us the information what I'm looking for. So what I'm looking here is if these analytics are there out of the box, and the one you see high and red, I have enabled all of them in my tenant. So there is something called Fusion running in behind, which is an AI. So when there are two medium type incident and the confidence level is high, so two medium becomes one high, basically. So if they are weak, then it may go to low. So that's the science behind showing these events high. So those are enabled. As you can see, pretty much everything is enabled in my tenant. Unknown IP location, for example. So in this example, what I'm going to cover is I want to see, let's say I have an Office 365 configured, and we talk about authentication. When it comes to cloud, we want to make sure authentication is strong, credentials are not leaked, because it could be through email phishing and could be through anything. So you want to protect that. So Microsoft has stopped supporting or discouraging, I would say, legacy authentication. And what legacy authentication it does, does not, it just, you can be fine just with username and password, versus a multi or advanced or modern authentication where you have to support multi-factor authentication. So I have set this up modern authentication in my environment, and but still, if I want to monitor what's going on, if there's an attempt on legacy authentication, because there are chances, there are different scenarios which can be using legacy authentication, could be a service account, for example. So there are so many legit cases. So if you want to monitor and want to make sure your identity and authentication pieces control, you have full visibility, there is something called legacy auth. So if you go to legacy auth, you have these three types of alert. One of them is just the alert, one of them just the legacy auth attempts, and one of them is login attempt using legacy auth itself. So you don't want to come and check or manually, or basically you want to make sure if you have implemented modern auth, or if you still have some things which are being attempting on those accounts, whichever the case is for legacy, or you want to have some visibility. So when you click those, the whole script is there and it goes here, like say 14 days. So what I would want to know is that you can select all three of them or one of them. Let's say for me, the most interesting one is attempts, basically any attempt, not the login, any attempt happens. I need to be get notified. And this is the actionable item I was talking about. That if something happens here, and these other tactics are going to be applied, like initial access, credential access, privilege escalation. So these are coming from MITRE framework. So these are the tactics, right? If you click here, and you may see the same tactics or different, let's find out. So yeah, so initial action and persistence. So this is different. So for me, and this one is also we can check. So that's what you need to understand when you set those up and have some understanding. So this is only initial access. So what I wanted to go is that if there is something, anything which is legacy authentication attempt, which has three tactics being applied, I want to be notified. And how can I do that? Very simple. We'll go here, create, and a Microsoft incident creation rule. When I go there, I will be able to create an incident rule, which will be then appear in my incident here dashboard, which I have already configured. If I go there, I can show you, and then it will show me the incidents created on the dashboard. This is very simplest example of SOAR, which is not SOAR 100%, it's not going to fix anything. At least if I come to my dashboard, if I see what incidents have happened in my environment, as you can see, I can see this one is being happened and I can find the details here. There's one alert generated for that and the date itself on which account, which is my account, the IP address and everything. So you see the power of this. So I don't have to go there back and manually run the analytics every 5 minutes or every hour. It's already being run by the system itself and generating the alert based on that. So what I'm going to do is that tactics are there, initial access and all that. So in this case, I know what's being done and IP addresses, everything's fine. So I'm not concerned. But of course, if it were a different IP address or something else, I would have been very much concerned. So that's why you have to look into that and have to have a better visibility. Give me the full what time it was in the morning, the tactics, initial access and everything, the IP and all that stuff. One more step further, let's see what does it give it. So I have not configured any playbook, so I'm going to go back basically. So I can even set up a playbook and automate it. What action do I need to take? For example, disable the account and something like that. I could have done it. But that's the idea. You can create a different number of incidents matching out of the box rule available. And then it can be displayed on the dashboard and give the summary of all incident, like admin activity I have configured, if somebody perform, I get the alert here, audit activity, even the legacy auth alert, right? And anomalous activity, right? So these are all there, I have configured it. So that's something you can start playing around and do it and see how does it work for you. So that's it for now. In this particular episode, you can see the incidents and everything. So I'll hope cover some more information in my future videos. Stay tuned. We'll see you in my next video. Thank you and bye.